So when I became mayor, it became really clear to me really quickly that while that is not a job without any power on the issue of coal transport and oil transport and climate change, there's not too dang much we can do except make noise. So we commenced to make noise as best we could. Spoke to my fellow city councilors, and we passed resolutions objecting to coal trains, objecting to oil trains, and encouraging the state to pass a tax or a price on carbon. And we also made noise as best we could at the state, because they have a little bit of regulatory authority, and with the federal government, because they have, in fact, the most regulatory authority about keeping us safe from the train tracks that I, in the old days, could probably hit with a baseball. It's just right here in our town, and I can't even imagine what a derailment would look like. So I got some heat for taking these positions, not because people think that burning coal is a great idea, but some people think that this is sort of a cop-out action that disempowers folks to speak up themselves, because it's not just the mayor who should make noise to the folks who can do something, but we should each make noise. So please remember to make noise and tell the elected leaders who have some leverage on this what you, their citizens, want. And in addition to making noise, and I'm not letting you off the hook on the making noise part, did I mention the making noise part? I got to have lunch with Jewell. It was lovely talking about his work and his art, because I think that in addition to talking about this, which is important, but that's only a part of our brain and a part of our heart. And I think experiencing art together, and as Pete Seeger taught me, singing together is another really important time to connect. So please join as we sing about that giant river down the hill. Down wild mountains and canyons she flew.